plants produce carbohydrates, like glucose, through photosynthesis. The bonds in glucose can be broken to make ATP, which is the usable energy molecule of the cell. But where does this happen? Cellular respiration occurs in the mitochondria. It's a complex set of chemical reactions and processes that convert organic molecules into adenosine triphosphate, ATP. The mitochondria take in oxygen and glucose and produce water and carbon dioxide and lots of ATP. Maybe you noticed that these chemicals are actually a bit familiar. Here's the equation for photosynthesis. Carbon dioxide and water, with energy from light, create glucose and oxygen. Those products of photosynthesis are the reactants of respiration. And the products of respiration are the reactants of photosynthesis. They're opposites. They cycle continuously. The main purpose of photosynthesis and cellular respiration is to take the energy from the sun and turn it into ATP, which is energy that the cells can actually use. Notice that oxygen is one of the reactants in cellular respiration. Our bodies and many other organisms have a way to deal with low or no oxygen environments as well. When oxygen is present, cells can perform aerobic respiration. Aerobic means requiring oxygen. So this is your typical respiration cycle, and it makes a lot of ATP. If you put the prefix A or an in front of a word, it means not. So anaerobic respiration means not requiring oxygen. Anaerobic respiration is not efficient, but it is a way to make ATP in a pinch. But we'll talk more about how that works next time. Thanks for watching this episode of Teacher's Pet. Don't forget to like and subscribe and follow me on Twitter @ScienceSciencePet.